Hello and welcome back to my channel of KST Sans Talks and to the Bioscope series. Hope you're all fine. Yesterday, there was a devastating cyclone of Amphan that have caused huge destruction everywhere in Bengal, in Orissa, and it has now moved to Bangladesh. In my locality also, there are many trees that have come down, and because of the trees coming down, the cars have been worsely hit and many properties have also been hit, and chimneys of restaurants have also come down. But only good thing is that I was fortunate enough to collect some neem flowers and fruits from a fallen tree. And this is the fallen tree, as you can see here, from where I have managed to collect some flowers and seeds. So today we'll be preparing neem oil from flowers and fruits of neem. Many people are fond of making neem oil from leaves, but fruits and seeds have a concentrated azadirachtin and nimbine. We have preferred to take fruits and flowers, as you see here, as because fruits and flowers, they are much more rich in the neem oil concentrate rather than the leaves. Neem oil, as we know, it is a good antihelminthic, that is, it helps to keep away some fungi, that is molds and some insects, ticks and mites, even though it helps to fight bed bugs and lice. Neem oil is also good for some skin problems, and it is often used in India and in the oriental places as a prophylaxis, or prophylactically it is used in case of smallpox as well as in case of chickenpox. Now we will trim these flower shoots or the inflorescence that we have got, so that when we put these shoots or when we put this inflorescence in oil, it gets submerged. We have taken, as you see here in this yolk, we have taken about 2 cups. This is a standard big cup, and this has a precious memory of mine. This was given by one of my favorite pupil whose birthday is today, and remembering such memories, I have chosen this cup. And this cup full of oil we have taken and we have added to the yolk, where we will be boiling the neem inflorescence as well as the fruits. So these are the inflorescence and these are the fruits. These are the typical fruits of neem. So first we'll chop the neem inflorescence into small pieces so that they get submerged in oil. As you see here, we are chopping them into small pieces. You have to take small lots at a time, otherwise it will be difficult to chop. And now these have been chopped, the entire mass. Say it is a mass of about 50 to 80 grams. So we have taken 2 cups of oil. We are pouring it in the oil, and some of the leaves that are very tender we have taken. We have tried to avoid the older and the matured leaves. And let's start boiling the inflorescence and the fruits. We'll put all of them together in the oil. I think we need some more oil. This oil we are adding so as to submerge the inflorescence. Now let's start off with the boiling. We'll keep the temperature to a very low so that very little oil gets volatilized. And the neem oil, since it is very much, this is an essential oil and it's volatile in nature, it won't get sublimed. So we'll start boiling, but we'll keeping it to a very low temperature. Now let's start off the induction. We can keep it to a, say it's 500 degrees, we'll try and keep it to 100 degrees at first. First let the oil gets boiled and then only we'll keep it to a low temperature. We'll rise the temperature a little bit, or it will take a long time, and as I free time unnecessarily will be bored. So I'm rising the temperature for the time being for the oil to simmer and start boiling. Then we'll lower the temperature of the yolk. And it started simmering. As you can hear the hissing sound, it has started simmering. Now we'll start lowering the temperature, otherwise it will get volatilized. And we'll almost keep it at a very low temperature, say about 50 to 80 degrees centigrade for about half an hour, till the color of the oil it gets changed. Oh, one thing I missed out, that is the oil that we have taken is sunflower. In many of the videos you'll find that people are using coconut oil. Since coconut oil is an indigenous oil and it is found where in India, it is abundant. It is found abundantly in India, so people prefer coconut oil, but I didn't resort to coconut oil because it is sticky. So we have preferred sunflower oil because it is a light oil and we can use it before going to fields or before going to a garden for trimming trees, since it is a light oil and it will help us to keep the mosquitoes away while I'm in a garden. Or it can also, one more thing, it also helps to keep snakes away, this essential oil. We'll rise the temperature for one more minute. Once again. Using these insulations, we'll just shake the oil so that the entire content it gets submerged. And after half an hour, we'll check for the color of the change in the color of the oil, and then we'll strain the oil with a strainer and keep it in a clean bottle. And whenever you need it as an insect repellent or you use it as a mosquito repellent, you can use it, and it remains fresh and good as anything for quite a long time, even up to 1 to 2 years. So now the oil has started boiling, so I am lowering the temperature and keeping it to a low, because neem oil is volatile oil. As the oil gets hot, you can see the entire inflorescence and the fruits, they have got submerged, and we have left it to simmer, but we won't be increasing the temperature so that the neem oil slowly diffuses from the tissues and it doesn't volatilize or it doesn't get vaporized, but it remains in the oil mix. See the color of the, since we are going through a very low flame, the color of the shoots still remain green, light green. This is how the neem oil looks like after heating the fruits and flowers in a sunflower oil for half an hour. The color has perhaps changed from the straw color of sunflower to greenish, and the oil is as clear because we have strained the oil. And you can keep this clear oil in a clean container for over a year and even up to a couple of years. Thanks for watching my video, and I thank one of my favorite students, Suma, who has given me this cup, and I dedicate this video to you in precious memory of your birthday. If you like my video, please do not forget to put a thumbs up, and please do not forget to share. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do subscribe now to get more updates, and hit the bell icon beside so that you get the updates as soon as I release a new video. We'll be meeting soon with a new topic, and if you got any suggestions to offer, if you have got any suggestions to give me, please drop in the comment section below.